World AIDS Day reminds us that HIV has not gone away. There is better understanding today about the condition, but there is still stigma and there is still discrimination.
I'm here with Carolyn Ansell, who is the volunteer manager at the Rainbow Hub. You're also a trustee, aren't you, at the Rainbow Hub? You're going to tell us ahead of World AIDS Day, which is on 1st December, Carolyn, a bit about the work of the Rainbow Hub first. So what's it all about here? I know you do some great work in the community.
Yeah, well, we've been running about 3 or so years now. We're completely volunteer-led and run. We're a signposting organisation for the LGBTQ community. So anybody who walks in that door, asks any questions, anything from problems with hate crime to the best venues to go to in the city for LGBTQ.
And you're kind of a signposting organisation. What does that actually mean in practice, Carolyn?
So what we do is we can't offer counselling, we can't offer advocacy, but we can signpost you to organisations that do, and signpost you to organisations that may be able to help you with homelessness, and organisations that might be able to help you with reporting hate crime and things like that. So we're very much here are a listening voice for people. We're a space where people can come and talk to us and seek advice, I suppose, on where they might go to get more specific help. People walk in the door and say, what do you do? Right, so that gives us the opportunity to talk them through. We've got a table full of leaflets I'm pointing at over there and things on the wall that people can take away. And we very much want to be this space for anybody in the LGBTQ community to come and ask for signposting services. So we might signpost you to the Clare Project, we might signpost you to the Racial Harassment Forum, we might signpost you to the council. So all, you know, all sorts of organisations.
We come up to World AIDS Day. That's an important kind of day to mark, isn't it? Just tell us about work that you do and other organisations you work with as well. I know the Martin Fisher Foundation you work with. Just tell us a bit about World AIDS Day, why that's important to mark.
Well,
that day.
It's important to everybody. It's important to our volunteers.
Yeah.
That's commemorated, and we are asked by Terence Higgins Trust to volunteer for that on the day, which we'll have some volunteers helping with that.
World AIDS Day is about remembering those who've died and supporting those for whom HIV and AIDS remain a daily reality. By getting involved and donating this World AIDS Day, you can help improve the lives of people living with HIV and ensure that support is there for everyone during this pandemic and beyond.
World AIDS Day is a chance for us to reflect on the achievements of recent years in providing support for people who are living with HIV/AIDS. It's also a time for us to consider the challenges that lay ahead, and particularly for those of us who really deeply care about this, to think very solemnly about the people whose lives have been lost.
One of the things that we're going to be doing is actually cleaning up Tay, the AIDS memorial up there in Newstead Gardens. So it's nice and spruced up for the day, so some of our volunteers will go up and clean it up a bit.
So back here with Carolyn Ansell, the voluntary manager at the Rainbow Hub. We're here in front of the statue, which we mentioned in the last interview. Just tell us a bit about the statue first, and we'll go on to talking a bit more about the Rainbow Hub.
Yeah, so this is a beautiful, beautiful statue by Romany Mark Bruce. That came funded by the Rainbow Fund, something that James Ledwood started. So it's sort of nice to be involved as the Rainbow Hub, because that also links us in with the fund and with James, yeah.
And
beautiful statue.
Yeah, exactly. And I know this is going to be a focal point for World AIDS Day as well, isn't it? So, which is important. It is every single year as well, isn't it? I know you have kind of special meeting here, don't you, on the first?
Yeah, so my understanding is there'll be a reading of the names here and a vigil before the choirs go, before people go and see the choirs in the church just across the road.
Brilliant. And then lastly, volunteering. How can people kind of get involved and volunteer? Because I know that's a big part of the work that you do as well.
Yeah, we're completely volunteer-led and run. So so anybody, you know, if you want to come and volunteer with us, just come along, talk to us in the hub, or email us at volunteer@therainbowhubbrighton.com, and we'll get back to you. And we'd love to see as many volunteers as we can from the community.
Brilliant. Okay, we're going to leave it there. People can just go on the website. If they Google Rainbow Hub, St James Street, they've got all the information there again, won't they? And they can find out about all of your services. So, Carolyn, thanks again for talking to us then, and all the best for the future.
Thanks Mark. Thank
Cheers.
You.
We at the Rainbow Hub stand in solidarity with people living with HIV. To learn and to educate, to fight prejudice and to raise awareness, to remember and to celebrate the lives of those we have lost to AIDS-related illness.